हेलो, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर के डब्ल्यू पवार फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, रयत शिक्षण संस्था राव बहादुर नारायणराव बोराव के कॉलेज श्रीरामपुर डिस्ट्रिक्ट अहमदनगर. फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डील ऑन द टॉपिक दैट इज प्लांट ग्रोथ रेगुलेटर्स और इन शॉर्ट व्हाट वी कॉल्ड इट एज द PGRS. The topic is from the class first year BSc. There is the paper, botany paper second, BO 1-2, Principles of Plant Science. So from that particular paper, there is the topic that is the plant growth regulators. And today we are going to see the what is plant growth regulators, definition of plant growth regulators, then types of plant growth regulators, then there is the first plant growth regulator, detail about the, that is what, auxins. Okay, so the plant growth regulators is again substance that are required in the minute quantity to the particular plant. So growth in plant is influenced by various naturally occurring organic substance other than the particular nutrients. Beside the nutrients, there is the some natural occurring substance that are required for the particular growth of the plant. These substances are synthesized within the plant body and required in very less amount. These growth substances that are synthesized within the plant body and which is required extremely in the particular large quantity. These substances are produced in one organ or what we called the one tissue, and transport to the other side where they produce specific effect on the growth and the development. Okay, then they control the various physiological processes. The growth regulators, it control the various physiological processes and regulate the growth, hence they are named as the growth regulators, or what we call it as the plant growth regulators, PGRS. So another very common terminology is here, you can listen, that is the particular hormones. That is very common terminology used by the Biles and Sterling in the year 1902. So hormone is used by the Biles and Sterling. So to distinguish them from animal hormones, they are named as the phytohormones. Here not for hormones, here the hormones that are distinguished from the animal hormones, so the name is given, that is what, there is the phytohormones. They are formed in a certain organs, or what we call phytohormones are formed in a certain organs or tissue of the particular plant and translocated to other side where they stimulate various morphological, physiological and the particular biochemical responses. Okay, so this is about the introductory portion of the particular growth regulators. There are the many scientists, they are defined the particular growth regulators. Here we can see one or two definitions given by the scientist about the growth regulators. So first of all, according to the Phillips or scientist Phillips in the year 1971, what is the growth regulator? Growth regulators is nothing but the plant hormones. Growth regulators is nothing but the plant hormone are the organic substance. This is the organic substance or substances which are synthesis in a particular cell. It is the organic substances which are synthesis in a particular cells and which are transported to other cells. Means it is synthesis in the particular cell and transport to the particular other cell where in extremely small quantities. But this is, keep in your mind always, that is what? This growth regulator that is required extremely in the particular small quantities influence the specific physiological process. Means what? In short, it is the organic substance synthesis in the particular cell and which are transferred to the other cells, and it is required in the particular small quantity or what we called minute quantity and influence the physiological processes according to the particular Phillips. Then phytohormones. Here next one thing is what? There is the particular phytohormones are the organic substances. So definition is again the meaning is same one, but theoretically it is again the difference. Phytohormones, here the not use the term growth regulator, here there is the use of the term, that is what? Phytohormones. Phytohormones are organic substance which are naturally produced in plant. Here there is the this particular substance that are naturally produced in plant, control growth. What it control? Control growth or other physiological function. It is the naturally occurring substance or naturally produced in the plant, control the growth or other physiological functions at a site remote from its place of production and active in extremely minute quantities according to the Thiemann in the year 1948. Okay, so this is these two definition that is given by the two scientists. There are the different definitions given by the different scientists. So this is about the particular growth regulators. Then types of growth regulator. Types of growth regulators. What are the types of growth regulators? There are the basic or broadly growth regulators that are broadly classified into the first of all natural growth regulators, and another one is the synthetic growth regulator. First type is what? Natural growth regulators, and second one is what? Synthetic growth regulators. Okay, so in definition we had seen there is the particular, it is synthesis in the particular naturally in plants. So these are natural produced in plant. First of all, the natural growth regulators, these are naturally produced in plant, or they are naturally occurring in plant. What we call, they are naturally occurring in plants. For instance, there is the example of auxins, then there is the gibberellin, cytokinin, auxin, cytokinin, gibberellins, then there is the fluorigin also there, then there is the ethylene, abscisic acid, etc. So these are the particular natural growth regulators. These are the natural growth regulators. They are naturally produced in the particular plants. Okay. Then synthetic growth regulators are of what? These are synthesized to a commercial level. This synthetic growth regulator synthesized to particular commercial level. For example, morphic tens, then malformis, malic hydroxide. So these are the examples of the particular synthetic growth regulator. So there are the two types of the growth regulator. Then first of all, today we are going to see the auxin. Okay, that is what natural growth regulator, auxins. Okay, auxin was the first hormone to be discovered. In that, there is the IAA, that is what? Indol acetic acid. Okay, IAA, indol acetic acid, is a first isolated physiologically. Okay, there are the many auxins. Examples of auxins are there, like the IAA, IBA, NAA, etc. Okay, so these are the examples of the auxin: IAA, indol acetic acid; IBA, indol butyric acid; and NAA, that is the naphthalene acetic acid. So it is synthesized in meristematic region, where, though I already told you, it is natural occurring growth substance, so it is synthesized in the particular meristematic regions. It is synthesized in the meristematic regions and other active growing region. Suppose growing region, okay, other active growing region, where it is synthesis, the in meristematic region of the particular plant, and other active growing region, like for instance, there is the example of the particular coleoptile apices, then root tips, then there is the growing seeds and other apical bud of the particular growing stem. So this is the site of the particular synthesis of the particular auxins: coleoptile apices, then growing tips, then germinating seeds, and apical bud of the growing stem. Here we can see the particular auxin. Suppose, for instance, there is the IAA, indol acetic acid. Structurally, the indol acetic acid, when we see the chemical structure of indol acetic acid, then it is like this. Here there is the CH2COOH. This is the structure of the indol acetic acid. Okay, then there is the properties of auxin. Properties of auxin. Properties of auxins. What are the properties of the particular auxins? Okay, auxin play an important role. First and foremost important property of the auxin, it play an important role to initiate or promote, promote cell division activity. Cell division activity. ओके सो दिस इज फोरमोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग अबाउट दी पर्टिकुलर ऑक्सिन टू इनिशिएट इट प्लेज द इंपॉर्टेंट रोल टू इनिशिएट और व्हाट वी कॉल प्रमोट दी सेल डिवीजन एक्टिविटी देन अनादर properties it promote the growth by cell elongation it promote the growth by cell elongation in stem or सेल एनलार्जमेंट सेल इलांगेशन इन स्टेम और व्हाट वी कॉल्ड सेल एनलार्जमेंट इन स्टेम बाय इलांगेशन ऑफ सेल्स सेल एनलार्जमेंट हियर देयर इज द सेल एनलार्जमेंट बाय सेल इलांगेशन by cell elongation behind the apical meristem okay so second property of auxin it promote the growth by cell enlargement of the stem by cell elongation behind the particular apical meristem then next property of auxin is of the it causes a softening of the cell wall it causes auxin causes the softening of cell wall softening of cell wall by removing the calcium linkage between linkage between pectin chains of the cell wall material and suppose here it causes the softening of cell wall by removing the particular calcium linkage between the pectin chain of the cell wall material Here there is the cell wall material and what will be the result? As a result of this, there is the increases in the volume of the particular cell. What will happen? It causes the softening of cell wall by removing the calcium linkage between the pectin chain of the cell wall material. And as a result of this, there is the particular increase in the particular volume. Okay. Then next property, auxin responsible for the initiation and promotion of cell division cell division in cambium okay this is again very important property of the auxin what is auxins are responsible for the particular initiation and formation of cell division cell division in the cambium. It means initiation of cell division and formation of cell division. As a result of this, or there is the this particular thing which is responsible for the secondary growth. Okay, so when such a thing is happen, then there will be the particular secondary growth. It is responsible for the initiation and promotion of cell division in case of cambium, and which is responsible for the secondary growth in the plant. Then next one property of auxin is what? It promote the growth of root. It promotes the growth of root at extremely low concentration. Okay. So, another important property, it promotes the particular growth of root. Generally, we use this particular hormone as the formation of root. So, promote the growth of root at extremely low concentration. Then, it prevents the abscission of the leaves and fruit. Next property is what? It prevents the particular abscission of leaves and fruit. Okay, so this is again the important property of auxin, that is, it prevents the abscission of the leaves and the fruit. Then last property of auxin is of what? It have a polar translocation from apex to the downward. Auxins have polar translocation, from apex to downward. This is again important property, apex to the particular downward. Here there is the polar translocation from apical region to the particular downward region. So this is the all about the properties of auxin. Okay, then what are the practical applications of auxins? Okay, practical applications of auxin. First of all, there is the particular root initiation. With the help of the auxin, there is the root initiation takes place in the particular many plants. Then it stimulate the advantageous root formation. In case of the particular plant. Then there is the use of the indole butyric acid and indole acetic acid that are widely used in the vegetative propagation of the particular plants. When lower quantity approximate, there is the 0.1 to 1.0% 0.1 to 1.0% that are used in the particular cuttings in case of the vegetative product propagation of plant. Then second application is of what? Induction of flowering. Induction of flowering in plants. Here there is the particular by application of the minute quantity of auxin, flowering can be accelerated or what we call induced in many plant. Okay, so in day neutral plant it act as the particular fluorigen. In case of the day neutral plant, auxins act as the fluorigen. Then there is the auxin plays the important role in fruit setting. It play again the important role in fruit setting. Application of minute dose of auxin like IAA, IBA, then there is the NAA and 2,4 chlorophenoxyacetic acid, that is 4-CPA. 4-CPA. What is that? There is the 4-chlorophenoxyacetic acid can increase the fruit setting in many plants. Then there is the auxins plays the important role in case of the particular parthenocarpy. Parthenocarpy means what? It is the phenomenon of development of fruits without fertilization. Phenomenon of development of fruits without fertilization. So here there is the auxin plays an important role. Auxin like IAA, NAA, IBA induce the enlargement of the particular ohuri and thus plant produce seedless fruits or fruit having without seedless. For instance, there is the particular example of the watermelon. Then next application of the auxin, that is the particular seed parthenocarpy, then prevention of the particular premature drop of the fruits. It is observed that the mature fruits of citrus, in case of particular lemon, orange, or there is a sweet lime, and citrus like then there is the grapes and apples found to be dropped before the particular time of commercial harvest. So this is due to the formation of abscission zone. This premature fruit drop due to the formation of abscission zone near the stalk of the fruit. By application of 2,4-D, then there is the IAA, IBA and 2,4 trichlorophenoxypropionic acid, abscission zone formation can be prevented. So like this, this auxin plays the important role when there is the premature drop of fruits. Then seed germination and dormancy. Auxin also increases the percentage of the particular seed germination of many plants. For instance, there is the example of papaya, custard apple, aster. When treated with the indole acetic acid, indole butyric acid and 2,4-D, there is the particular increases in the seed germination. Then some synthetic auxins like ammonium thiocyanate, 2% solution of the particular ammonium thiocyanate can break the dormancy in case of the particular potato tubers. So here auxin plays the important role in seed germination and seed dormancy. Then it is used for the particular weed control. Auxin used for the weed control. Some synthetic auxin control the growth and kill the plant. Hence they are used as the control of the particular weed. they have very selective action. For instance, there is the 2,4-D kill the broad-leaved herbaceous dicotyledonous weed. Okay, so it plays the important role in the particular weed control. Then there is the tissue and the organ culture. This is important because tissue cultural studies that are runs on the particular growth hormones or plant hormone, and there is the artificial initiation of the roots and the shoots, and for this particular purpose the auxin play important role in the root formation in tissue and organ culture. Especially one can say there is the use in the micro propagation and there is the callus formation. So there are the auxins that are used alone: indole acetic acid, indole butyric acid, naphthalene acetic acid, 2,4-D, or auxin in combination with the particular cytokinin. So this is about the practical application. So friends, this is about the plant growth regulators, their definition, types, and we can take the one plant growth regulator in this video. Another plant growth regulators that is the cytokinin, gibberellin and ethylene, we will see in coming videos. Okay, thank you very much.